Welcome back, guys. Today, week 9 starts off with a little some stride repeats, so we're gonna be working on our cadence today. Today's run starts off with a 10-minute warm-up run right into 12 repeats of a 20-second run with our cadence between 150 to 200. Just from like previous runs, I know that like 150 to 200 is pretty fast. So we're gonna be running not a sprint, it's gonna be like a very fast but controlled pace. So we're gonna be hitting a 20-second, basically a sprint with a 45-second recovery period right into our next interval. We're gonna be hitting 6 in a row, I believe that's what the program calls for, with like a 2-minute break in between, and then we're gonna hit another 6. And then like a 10 to 15 minute cool down. Now after that, I will be taking you guys through race day running shoes. What shoes have I been wearing this whole time? And what shoes am I gonna wear for race day?
I'm picking wildflowers.
Felt good. It felt good. Oh. The thing for me is that up at school, I've been practicing on I've been like training for the past like 2 months in the cold, running a lot inside and stuff, and the weather lately has just been so nice, so I'm not used to the heat. 10-minute warm up into 12 repeats of 20 seconds, followed by a 45-second jog, and right into a 10-minute cool down. So that felt good. I'm happy with that. Not a bad workout at all. Stride repeats in the books. Honestly, I like these kind of workouts just because when you work on like your stride and your cadence for like weeks after weeks after weeks, you can see it incorporating into your runs. Like you just feel lighter on your feet, you feel faster. So it all compounds, builds up. And it's one of the things I love about this program. I present to you the Hoka Rincons. They're super lightweight. They're like 7.5 ounces. The heel toe drop is like 5 centimeters or millimeters. I forget what it's measured in, but it just fit my foot right. And that's one of the other things I want to talk about is kind of the reason why I chose this shoe. All right, so one of the reasons I chose the Rincons was because I guess it's called like your stride. I got like a stride analysis at a running store, and basically like you run on a treadmill barefoot and they videotape you and they break down like your foot placement, like if you're like if when you hit the ground, if like your ankle pronates, if you have like a neutral foot, those kind of things. So when I got my step analyzed and like when I was running on a treadmill, they videotape you and they bring it up and they show you like all the angles that your foot hits, and like it'll show like your, it's basically like a mold of your foot and stuff. When they break it down on the computer, you can see like what foot is bigger than the other foot, which all just kind of helps you figure out like what kind of shoe you end up getting. So after I did my running analysis, the recommended shoe for me was the Hokas. And I've been looking into this brand for a long time before that. So I kind of had like the Hoka shoe in mind. Like I just, the Hokas, like these are like the first, this is the first pair of Hokas I ever had. And I'm so glad that my preferred shoe from the running analysis came out to be the Hokas. It was the Hokas and the Brooks. And I've had Brooks before when I ran cross country a while ago. And I love the Brooks, but honestly, like nothing compares to the Hoka. They're so comfortable. Like the Rincons are just an all around shoe because the Clifton 6s are more built for like, there's a little more cushion and stuff. There's a little more like structural support around the ankles for like long distances and stuff. Not really built for speed, but this shoe is built for like, it's like the all around shoe. So, and I'm not trying to do anything crazy. I'm not trying to break a world record or anything. So I went with this shoe just because it's great for speed. It's lightweight. Comfortability, it's just an amazing shoe. These are the Rincons, and I've been training with those for a while now. So the new shoe that I picked up is actually the exact same shoe. I just love the Rincons, and I saw these are the Ironman edition. You can see those there, it's the Ironman edition. But I just love these colors, it stood out. So I will be wearing these on race day. Here is the secret. When you get your foot analyzed at this Roadrunner Sports is an amazing running store. And this is the secret to success. So when you get your foot analyzed, you can get like a custom made sole that fits your foot to a T. Like this will not fit on anyone else's foot except mine. So like I got my foot molded. This arch fits my foot arch perfectly. It's like a sturdy material. Like you can't bend it from here. Like it's hard. It only bends right there. And I got these I love because I put on the Hokas today. I got these new shoes today actually. And like before I took out, like there's just the manufacturing sole, which is basically just to, like cover the stitches and stuff. But I put my foot in it and I was like, I can like wobble my foot. It just doesn't feel right. But once I got my custom sole made for my foot, like it just feels like you running with a sock on that is like tight to your foot. Like there's no room for to slide or anything. Especially after you get your foot like analyzed, they will come out with like the actual size shoe that you need. And like in regular shoes, I wear like a 10 and a half to 11 in the running shoes. And Hoka might just run small, I'm not sure, but I was a 9.5. So my left foot was 9.5, my right was a 9. So you obviously go with the bigger shoe size. So these are 9.5s. I love these. Just got them today. Love these colors, they stand out. Super nice, but super lightweight, like they're so light. And with these in, it just makes it like this shoe was just built especially for you. So it's one thing I love about the Hokas and Roadrunner Sports is that they give you the opportunity to not only just pick out a shoe that's for you, but like customize a sole that's meant for your foot. And I had shin splints like beginning of this program, and that was like before I was running in the Hokas and the customized sole, but after like the Hokas and the sole, I never got shin splints again. So love these. But that is pretty much it, guys. I will be wearing these on race day, April 19th. Thanks for watching, guys, and be sure to stay tuned for the next video. We got some good upcoming videos. I'm looking to get a camera soon. So stay tuned for more. I think we're gonna have in the next month or so, we'll be getting ready to film race day footage. So yeah, thank you guys for watching and stay tuned for this.